I'm going to discuss about Sand Meyer's reaction. Generally, Sand Meyer's reaction is used to convert an aryl diazonium salt to an aryl halide or aryl cyanide using a catalyst copper 1 halide or cyanide. Here you should remember, mainly if the Sand Meyer's reaction is used to convert aryl diazonium salt to an aryl halide or aryl cyanide, the major reagent used for this reaction is copper 1 halide or copper 1 cyanide. Do you know how to prepare diazonium salt? Okay, then we discuss about the preparation of diazonium salt. That process is called diazotization. An aromatic primary amine when treated with mineral acids like HCl and sodium nitrite. The formula of sodium nitrite is NaNO3. At cold condition, zero to 5 degrees Celsius, an aromatic diazonium salt is formed. This reaction is called diazotization. Actually, this reaction is called diazotization. During diazotization reaction, we get aromatic diazonium salt. This aromatic diazonium salt is used for the preparation of aryl halide. Then we discuss about the preparation of aryl halide using aromatic diazonium salt. This is the structure of diazonium salt. Then we discuss about the diazotization. When aromatic primary amine, when treated with the mineral acids like HCl and sodium nitrate, at a cold condition 0 to 5 degrees Celsius or 273 to 278 Kelvin, we get benzene diazonium halide as a product. Actually, this reaction is known as diazotization reaction. After the diazotization reaction, we get benzene diazonium halide as a product. The next step is the preparation of aryl halide. When mixing the solution of freshly prepared diazonium salt with cuprous chloride or cuprous is bromide. Results: in the replacement of the diazonium group by chlorine or bromine atom. Actually, in first step, diazonium salt is produced, then this diazonium salt is used for the preparation of aryl halide. The freshly prepared diazonium salt is mixed with cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide. Here, replacement of diazonium group by halogen atom take place. Here, diazonium group is replaced by chlorine or bromine. We get chlorobenzene or bromobenzene. Then we discuss about the reaction. When aromatic diazonium salt is treated with the cuprous halide, we get aryl halide. Here X may be chlorine or bromine, we get chlorobenzene or bromobenzene. Then the byproduct is N2, nitrogen gas. When aromatic diazonium salt is treated with the CuBr in presence of HBr, we get bromobenzene. When aromatic diazonium salt is treated with the CuCl in presence of HCl, we get chlorobenzene as a product. And byproduct is N2 and HCl. Replacement of the diazonium group by iodine does not require the presence of cuprous halide and is done simply by shaking the diazonium salt with potassium iodide. The formula potassium iodide is Ki. Here you should remember, the replacement of diazonium group by iodine does not require the presence of cuprous halide. In previous case, we already discussed the preparation of chlorobenzene and also bromobenzene by using cuprous halide. It may be copper 1 bromide or copper 1 chloride. But in case of iodobenzene, the diazonium salt is mixed with potassium iodide, and simply by shaking we get iodobenzene as a product. The reaction not require the cuprous halide. This is the reaction when diazonium salt is simply shaking with potassium iodide. We get iodobenzene as a major product and also nitrogen gas is a byproduct during the reaction. When aromatic diazonium salt is treated with different reagent, we get different alkyl halide, depends upon the reagent. In first case, if the diazonium salt is treated with the CuCl in presence of HCl, we get chlorobenzene as a product. In second case, if the diazonium salt is treated with the CuBr in presence of HBr, here CuBr means a copper 1 bromide in presence of HBr, hydrogen bromide. After the reaction, we get bromobenzene as a product. In third case, if the diazonium salt is treated with Ki, that is potassium iodide, this reaction take place by simply shaking. After the reaction, we get iodobenzene as a product. Here you should remember one thing. If the cuprous halide is replaced by copper powder, the reaction is called Gutterman reaction. The reaction is called Gutterman reaction. For the preparation of iodobenzene, the disodium salt is treated with potassium iodide. Here you should remember one thing, the preparation of iodobenzene requires iodide. There is no need for the cuprous halide. And also one thing, if the cuprous halide is replaced by copper powder, this reaction is called a Gutterman reaction. The Gutterman reaction we will discuss later. Okay.